Fogel let Eitan Fogel's words wash over him in the distance. He'd known. He'd already known, but having it confirmed on the phone from 3,500 miles away by the only father he had ever known was an extraordinary moment in his life. Automatically, he began to reflect on what he'd already learned from this, so far, brief conversation. Adam was the natural son Eitan Fogel had longed for. So what did that make him, David? Not the much-desired firstborn, that was for sure. Another thought occurred to him. He had stopped listening to his father and interrupted him anyway.
Dad, am I a Jew?
Of course you're a Jew, David. We brought you up a Jew. You were circumcised. You had your bar mitzvah, didn't you? What more could we do?
So my birth parents were not Jewish?
No, but that doesn't matter, David. You're a Jew, all right.
Right. Good night, Dad.
Fogel ended the call before his father, or the man he had always thought was his father, could say any more. Mary stood anxiously by Fogel's side. She looked at him inquiringly.
I'm not even a Jew, he whispered.
As a little boy, he'd sat listening to Eitan's stories of their family history, the good and the bad, the relatives who had died in the Holocaust all over Europe, those who had escaped and forged new lives, as Eitan, one of Germany's kinder transport refugees, had done. Fogel had mourned and rejoiced at these tales of his Jewish heritage, but the heritage was a lie. The Jewish relatives were a lie. Even his own father was a lie.
Is that what Eitan said? Mary queried.
No, he said I'd been circumcised and had my bar mitzvah. Thought I was a Jew, all right.
Fogel spat the last words out.
Well, that's true, isn't it?